Hello everybody and welcome to Train Sim World 3. Today we are having a look at a classic, an oldie but a goodie, as some would say. We are here at London Paddington and we are taking this 12 car class 387 to, we're taking it to Slough, stopping at Hayes and Harlington. We're on the fast lines, should be, yep. And there's an HST, there's a 166, there's a few other things dotted around the line. Let's get the doors appropriately set. We will set the shoes up. No, we don't. We just set the AC system select, don't we? Because I want the good acceleration. Okay, and pan up. Pantograph feel like going up? Yes, no, maybe. 4, 5. Auxiliary's on. No, that's okay, right, we'll set AC system select back. Come on. Work with me. Don't be a dog. There you go. Pan up. No, I want pan up. Come on, do a thing. Raise pantograph. Right, can I take power? No. The aug's on. Oh, the 700 is so much nicer than this. Just flick the switchies over and it goes. What's going on? Is the pantograph up? Oh, it is. Okay. Oh, I can take power. Okay. Easy peasy. Let's get moving. Starting speed limit's 20. Oh, is it? What is it? 40? Okay. Can do. Right, a slight delay there, but we're off and racing. So top speed is 110 because we're on AC, so we'll be making full use of that. Now, I did see a video from a while back that these trains were more or less able to keep to HST times from was it Cardiff to London all the way? Like, even though they were 15 miles per hour slower, just the acceleration of them and the fact that they're electric made them better than the HSTs, and they can be longer than the HSTs. So, yeah, Electrostars, HSTs, from a practical perspective. Might not be high speed proper, but they're not slow speed. The thing on that traction light. This light down the bottom, it turns on sometimes and not other times, and I don't quite understand why. Lighthouse says Slough in the top though, that's nice. A good touch. But I wonder, does the side of the train say where we're going? Oh, it does! This train calls out Hayes and Harlington and Slough. Cool. Does it say that in the middle? It like inside as well? Or... Right, we'll get up to 50 miles an hour. Oh, it does as well. That's very nice. What are we up to? 50 or 60? Just to 50. We can get up to 100 soon. And then 110. Oh, very exciting. Now, we will be running without overhead wires for a little bit of this, but, you know, what can you do? And I mentioned earlier, oldie but goodie, for ages and ages, a video of... a reskin video of one of these trains, a class 387 in Gatwick Express. I believe at the time I would have just used a class 377. Was my most viewed video for ages and ages, and it still is one of my most viewed, not the most, but one of the, and I mean I can see why. It is, it's nice. Anyway, let's get up to 100. Let us do that. Here comes something. On the fast or the slow? Fast, is that? Or is that coming out of the depot? No, that's coming out of the depot. That's the four-car unit on the slows. Bye-bye. And as we roar through 70 miles an hour, someone's trundling through at, like, 20 or something. How are our friends behind us doing? HST, oh no, that's the 166. 166 is moving and HST is moving. We should be able to rocket away from the HST, like properly race away. Because there's no way it would be able to put up this much speed. No way in hell it could do this. And here is another HST, I believe. Yep. And I'm pretty sure there's another one coming from Slough. Or was that the one I sent from Slough? It's come from Slough, it's made fucking good time. So where is Slough? Is that Slough? Don't know. Genuinely don't know. Okay, coming up to 100. There it is. Come off the power. Touch a... Actually, no, I'll just go up to 110. Oh! But I really do like the opportunity to drive these trains outside the limitations of the timetables. I like Scenario Planner a lot, and I love the livery design and the you know, the creativity that people can use it for. But I do love the fact that they've given us rights. You know, Dovetail can be faulted in many, many ways, and I have done a lot of faulting in the past. And I continue to do a lot of faulting, and I suspect when more details are revealed about trains in World 4, I'll be a bit cynical about them. But this is the fact that they've given us the ability to use the AC and they've modelled it fully is pretty cool. Bet you've never seen a Class 377 on the Southern network move that quickly. Oh, here's our... Yeah, that was supposed to be an GWR HST. That's, I selected a GWR HST, so clearly that's worked. I mean, we're more or less doing 125. We're doing 122 at the moment. The speedo can't go any higher because we're off the scale. But we're doing, my rail driver is telling me that we're doing 122. Let's have a look, pop that up, just verify that, yeah. So we're above the maximum limit of this train, but it's just, it is, they are nice, they are pretty speedy trains. You have to give it to them. And the HST, the gap keeps getting bigger. And the 166 would be miles behind that, because they've really blunted the acceleration on the 166s. And these have good brakes as well, much better than the HSTs, so we can hold off on the brakes for a while. But I wouldn't like to hold off too long. I reckon we'll go now a full brake application. Yeah, look at that. That is a whopper of a brake. Like there's 90. It's too quick. Are we taking a diverging route? No. Yeah, my God, that these those brakes are phenomenal. We could have probably braked from 1 mile. I'm just so used to driving the HST along here in 1 mile and you'd go soaring out the other end of the station. Ah, holy moly. Good brakes. Okay, notch three again. Come through 45 miles an hour hitting the platform. It's pretty reasonable speed. The game manual tells you to hit platforms at 25, but once you get better at driving, you realize that is a ludicrously slow speed. Okay, we're gonna pull right up to the end of the platform because there's gonna be. It's a long train, it's gonna be a squeeze. Come on, stop. Grab the doors. I hope I'm not hanging over the front. Nope. Am I hanging off the back? Yes, a lot. Oh, not that much. Only one door. And not by much. Pantographs are still up. I wasn't expecting that. Got these stupid donuts on the side. I wonder if that's realistic. These are interesting pantographs because they don't have a sort of second arm underneath to hold them up. Unless that's sort of contained inside. They got their aerofoils because they won't stay against the wire properly. Okay. And let's get moving again. It's been a wheel slip, even. Getting a bit of sparking. See, soar back up to 125. I want to see the pantographs dropping, because I know they do. And I would like to see it. Okay, why it's clipping through the pantograph again a bit. That's pretty loud. You can still hear me though, because I've pumped up my microphone volume. I'm pretty sure the pantographs drop about here where the wires stop. Do they? Do they not? Coming through 90 miles an hour. Pretty speedy. Oh, pantograph's still up. And the other ones. If I come into the cab and come back. Okay. Well, well, well. And how far behind are the HST? Does it have to stop? Ah, so it's on. Oh, it would have been on single yellows now. I know the pantographs do drop, I'm just expecting. Wondering when they will. Maybe they don't. It It is pretty incredible that when this route was made, the electrification only went as far as Hayes, whereas now it goes all the way out to Wales, goes all the way to Cardiff and a bit further, I'm pretty sure. You know. That's how they were able to have these trains fill in for the 800s when they discovered they had cracks in them. Classic IET. Fucking IET. Fucking useless piece of Japanese shit. I'm just joking. I am just joking. Make that very clear. So yeah, the HST is already back to running on greens because we're more or less at its speed already. Very slow. Oh, it's there. Okay, it's not the other one I was thinking of. Oh, great. GWE with these trains would be fucking fantastic. I'd love that. An updated GWE with a bit more interest. Okay. Ding-a-ling. And based on the braking performance from the previous station, I will wait until we're only a mile out before initiating the brake application. Okay, there's a single yellow. Oh, I reckon this will be a good stop. There's not much I can do at the moment, other than just sit back. Yeah, the HST is still running on green signals. These things, they are pretty incredible trains. I mean, people hate on them, and I get it. The seats look fucking uncomfortable. But from an actual raw performance perspective, these things can do commuter runs. These things can do, like, almost metro-style trains. These things can do almost high speed. Like, basically high speed. It is unbelievable how... It was like a Swiss Army knife of the train, you know. Bombardier built a great design. Yeah, they really should have shipped it around the world more. I mean, they really are designed for the UK, I guess. Let's just forget about that one. Should be in the whole platform then. Oh. I refuse to believe that the platform at Slough is shorter than the one at Hayes and Harlington. But okay then. Fair enough, I guess. Maybe. Maybe not. Who knows? Our HST friend should be slowing down now. Yeah. Oh, let's get the rest of the doors set to locked. And that is the end of this video. I hope you've enjoyed. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all later. Goodbye.